Hi everyone and welcome back. Today I have 10 cards for you using the new Spellbinders card kit. This is one of my most asked videos and I couldn't stay away from making 10 cards with this card kit because as you can see, it is a must-have. You will be able to make tons and tons of your Christmas cards. So just like always, let's take a look on what's included. Once again, it is packed with products. You will see that it has a lovely color combo with greens and reds, traditional ones, but including aquas and pinks as well. So always you get a leaflet with three card ideas, and at the back you will be able to see how you can put together the little Santa. Now Santa is a set of dies and it gives you different bits and pieces that you can put together. You can die cut it from white cardstock and color it in, or use colored cardstock to cut out all the pieces. You even get a couple of speech bubbles. And here is an image on how he looks like if you put him together. I think he's absolutely adorable. Now in the kit, just like every month, you get some essentials such as foam tape, a roll of double-sided tape, you will get 10 envelopes and 10 pre-folded cards, that's 4.25 by 5.5. And since this is a Christmas kit, you get a bag of sequins in a red color to add lots of sparkle on your projects. Now the stamp set is all about Christmas, lovely big sentiments and smaller ones. You get lots of snowflakes and this adorable reindeer. And now let's move on to stickers. This is a pack of chipboard stickers. They are nice and thick, and you get lots and lots of elements that make great focal points for your cards. If you notice, you get that lovely reindeer that you get on the stamp set, plus lots of tags, a Christmas tree, many sentiments, as well as a wreath. Lovely focal points, and I will be using some of them on the cards that I'm sharing today. You also get a pack of puffy stickers. These are tiny little ones that you can use to embellish your cards. You get snowflakes, little trees, even creatures and Santa. And here is another pack of puffy stickers, this time full of sentiments, again in the same color combo. Every month you get a 6x6 paper pad, and this month is no exception. I absolutely love the designs on this one. You get 20 different designs, 2 pages for each design, and they are not double-sided. So altogether you get 40 pages, and I absolutely love the color theme. You get traditional greens and oranges. Some of the papers do have some foiling, if you notice, but you also get aquas and pinks, which I think are really trendy. Now let's take a look at the cardstock. Lots and lots of cardstock here. 8 different colors plus the golden one that you always get on your kits. And now let's move on to my favorite part, where we get to take out all the cutouts from this little pack. There are more than 200 pieces in here, so you get lots and lots to play with. And you get twice every design. I'm going to use many of them on my cards today, and I still have tons and tons to make even more cards. I cannot recommend this card kit enough. This is $39 if I'm not mistaken. You will find the link below, and you get tons of sentiments, as you can see on the right. They do have some foiling on top, so they do add sparkle and shine on your Christmas cards. You get many critters as well as Santa, even a snowman. You do get wreaths, trees, ornaments, gifts, banners, tags, so many things. Snowflakes, I think you will have a blast playing with it. It is definitely one of my favorites they have come up with. So let's start making cards. For my first one, I'm going to play with these die cuts, and I do have the reindeer from the stickers. Now this is a chipboard sticker and I like to keep it with the backing so that I can play around with it before I decide where I want to stick it. I did use some dies that I had on my stash to cut out those snowbanks, but you can just use your scissors. For my sky, I did cut out a piece from one of the pattern papers included. And I'm going to stick the snowbanks. One goes completely flat, the second one with foam squares to add some dimension. So I am going for a little scene, and you can repeat the same thing again and again. And instead of using the reindeer, you can use, for example, the penguins. or the elves. There are so many little creatures that you can use as your focal point for a similar design. I am sticking down the trees, each one in a different level of the snowbanks. This way I end up having the illusion of dimension, so some of them looks like it's far at the back and the other at the front. Rudolph is going to go on the top snowbank, so I need to add some foam squares at the back of his head to make sure that he is nice and leveled. And if you like, you can stick one of the red sequins included in the kit to make his nose shiny. I'm going to leave it as it is. So I'm sticking down my sentiment, and then this panel is going to go on one of the pre-folded cards that were included in the kit. For all the cards that I'm sharing today, I'm making sure that I'm staying with the supplies that were included in the kit, except from some basic dies or tools. For example, here I used the die for the bangs, but of course you can use your scissors to create those slopes. Here are some close-up photos on the first card for today, and let's move on to the second card, where I will be working with the die-cut Santa as my focal point. I picked this pattern paper and I cut out a panel, and I'm going to cut out a window using this stitched die. If you don't have the same die, you can use any rectangle die or you can use a circle die to create a window. I'm not going for a shaker card. However, I want to have a window where I can tuck inside my Santa. I decided to stick this panel with foam tape at the back, but on an angle, just to make it more fun. And then I'm going to use foam tape at the back of my Santa and tuck it inside the window. For my sentiment, I went with Not Your Nice that I stuck on top of a white panel so that it stands better. And I love how Santa is holding the gifts as if he is balancing whether you are naughty or nice. That's why I had that idea to stick everything on an angle. And you can see here some close-up photos on the second card. Now let's move on to the third card, and for this one I'm going to play with the ornaments. I picked the pattern paper with the ornaments on top, and I did cut out a panel from the red cardstock from the kit. I'm going to stick this one on this golden cardstock just to have borders on each side. Of course, you can be more frugal and just cut out two thinner strips and stick them on each side. Now I'm going to stick this on top of my pattern paper, and this is going to be the base for my card. At the back of my ornaments I have foam tapes, and I'm also securing pieces of thread with double-sided tape so that they look as if they are hanging from the top of the card. For a similar design, there are many other ornaments that you can hang from top, or even gifts. There are lots and lots of different sizes and designs of gifts that you can hang, if you like, from the top of a card. Now at the back I'm using some double-sided tape so that I can secure those strings at the back. I cut off the excess string at the back, and now I'm using my glue and I will stick some of the sentiments that are included in the kit. So first I stuck down the green one that says deck the halls, and then on each and every one of those ornaments I'm going to stick holiday, sparkle and cheer. The fun part about these walls is that they come in different colors and they are foiled. Then all I have to do is to stick this panel on top of a standard card, and I am done. If you like, you can add even more sparkle by embellishing all those ornaments with gems. I decided to leave them as they are. So here are some close-up photos on my card with the ornaments, and let's move on to another card where I will be working with non-traditional Christmas colors. So I picked this pattern paper, the pink one, for my base. And I always like to cut it slightly smaller than the standard card to end up having that white border. And I'm going to create a little scene with those gifts, as well as the little elf. So I'm going to stack them, decide how I like them, and I'm going to stick them down. For the gifts, I'm going completely flat with Nouveau Deluxe glue at the back. And for the elf, I'm going to use some foam squares to add a little bit of dimension. A really quick and simple card, but super adorable, and I finished it off by adding no peeking on top of the gifts. The next card is again very quick and simple looking. I am going to use that chipboard sticker with the row of houses. So I'm working on a blue panel. This is the cardstock included in the kit that I cut it out. And I'm adding some white paint on top to be the snow. Now I have a snowbank, which is a leftover from the first card that I did. I'm going to align it at the bottom. And I'm going to create a little scene again, tucking the houses behind the snowbank. And then all I have to do is to stick a sentiment. For that I went with a die cut that says Noel in gold foiling. A really quick and simple card, but I think it looks really clean and simple, and sometimes these are my favorites to stand. I have one of my pre-folded cards that were in the kit. I'm going to stick that there, and here are some close-up photos. And I just want to say that you don't have to overthink your cards. Sometimes very simple designs are really pretty. For my next card, I'm working with one of the green pattern papers. Again, I cut it to be smaller than my card to have that white border. And then I'm going to have that car as the focal point. I'm going to create one of those cluster cards where I play with different bits and pieces that were included in the die cut pack. And I'm going to create something that looks pleasing to the eye. I am playing with shapes, different colors, as well as shiny elements. And once I'm happy with how they look, I'm going to stick everything down. Now, when it comes to card designing, I absolutely love creating little scenes on front of my cards, but I also like cluster cards like this one. And this kit is perfect for these type of cards because they give you so many different elements to play with that makes it really easy. Plus, all the elements that are included match together, pattern papers, die cuts, stamps, so it's really easy to put things together like that. They have actually done the difficult part for you. To finish off my card, I did stick down the number 25 as well as season greetings as my sentiment, and here are some close-up photos. If you want to recreate these cards, feel free to do so. You will find photos on my blog. The link is down below in the description area. Let's make one more of those cluster cards. For this one, I want my focal point to be that little reindeer. Or maybe it is a deer, I'm not sure about that. So anyway, I'm starting with different tags as well as sentiments that I'm going to stack one on top of the other. And notice that for this tag, just to add some extra texture, I did thread a little bit of white string, and I do have glue on the right side so it lays flat, but on the left where the string is threaded, there is some foam tape at the back. So I play with dimension and different textures and colors. So behind the deer, I want to have those two pine trees. And I like the fact that they are different colored. I'm going to stick the other one slightly higher so it looks like it is taller, although it actually isn't. I'm going to stick the deer on top, and this time I'm using foam tape at the back. I wanted to add a touch of red, that's why I'm using this banner, and this has foiling dots on top, which are absolutely stunning. And I'm going to add a couple of sentiments. The green one says jingle all the way, and I have a black one that says sparkle. And I want to bring that red towards the top, so I'm going to stick one of those poinsettias, just tuck it behind my deer. And I'm going to finish it off by adding a black star that has foiling, however, so it is shiny. And if you are wondering why I picked the black star, it is kind of a feeling of what looks pleasing to the eye. So I do have a black sentiment, and I wanted to balance that somehow by bringing one more black element on top of my card. That's why I brought that black star. I'm sticking this panel on top of this pattern paper with the red stripes, and this will go on top of a pre-folded card. So here are some close-up photos. For my next card, I'm going with a little scene. Again, I'm using the pattern paper with the snowflakes, and I did cut a strip out of it, which I'm going to stick on top of my card towards one side, just for some added interest. I have a snowbank again that I'm going to stick at the bottom. And then as my focal point, I decided to go with that pink bunny Is it a bunny? I think so, by the tail. And I think he is just adorable. I'm going to pair him with that lamp post and a sentiment that says Merry Christmas in pink, and it has some foiling underneath that says to you and your family. To finish off my card, I'm going to use Cloud 9 Nouveau Drops, and I'm going to add some drops at the center of some of the snowflakes at the background. Again, for this card, I didn't overthink it, just three elements made the card and just a piece of patterned paper, but I think that it looks really pretty. For my next card, again, I'm going with a cluster of die cuts. My focal point is going to be that snow globe, and I'm going to embellish it with different bits and pieces, again, banners and different sentiments. This time I'm not working on a pattern paper panel, however I'm going to work directly on that white card base. Sometimes I really embrace that white space all around, although it's not really easy for me. However, I did have to add some dimension, so some of the elements do have foam tape at the back, while others lay completely flat. For the sentiments, I went with three words: Noel, Be Merry, and Cheer. Again, they are all gold foiled, but I did deliberately pick different colors. So I have one sentiment in black, in red, and in light green. And I finished it off by adding a little white bow made out of thread. And let's move on to the last one, and probably this is one of my favorites from the whole set. I am going to create a tower of gifts, and on top I'm going to have Santa. I am working on a white panel, and I'm not using any foam tape here. I'm just going to stick everything down completely flat. I did pick three different gifts, of course in different colors, just for some interest, and other bits and pieces like a candy cane, a little tag that says ho ho ho, as well as little poinsettias that I'm going to use to embellish the gifts on the left and on the right. Keep in mind that these type of card kits by Spellbinders sell out really quickly. If you like this one, make sure to be fast. I think you are going to have a blast. Tons and tons of products inside. I cannot recommend it enough. I had lots of fun. After making my 10th card, I still have tons of pattern paper, lots of cardstock, and I haven't even used the Santa Claus dies or the stamps. So here I am using scraps of that pattern paper that I used in a previous card, and I am creating some borders on each side. Finally, I'm going to stick this one on a red panel that's 4.25 by 5.5, and this whole thing is going to go on top of one of the pre-folded white cards. So here are some close-up photos. And yes, I think this is my favorite from all 10. Don't forget to let me know down below in the description area which one of the 10 cards was your favorite. I really love to read that. Now, here are all the cards that I made for today using the Spellbinders card kit of the month. You will find the link down below, as well as everything I used to create these cards. I hope that you had fun today, that you got inspired, and I wish you will all have a lovely weekend. Thank you.